Well, let me start with my own story. I was one of three daughters. I have four daughters of my own. And we were not rich people, but I consider ourselves extraordinarily blessed and extraordinarily wealthy. Because for me and my parents and for my sisters, it was an equal and wonderful opportunity at a shot at education, exactly the same as my brother. And we're talking about another century now. We're talking about more than 50 years ago. So I grew up in a very progressive home, and I carried that forward with my own four daughters. But to answer the larger question, do girls in India have it tough? Yes, they do. Do we discriminate against them when it comes to education? Yes, we do. And that is the tragedy of India. And the more we work on parents, actually, the better it will be for the next generation and the next. I see the change. It's already there. I see it in our own lives and in our homes. All the domestics who work in our homes, all the ladies who work who are illiterate, have made sure that at least a part of their salary goes towards educating their daughters. And that, I think, is a very, very significant shift. But of course, discrimination exists. If the ladies at our home, and even ladies from elite backgrounds, if they have resources that are necessarily limited, it will go to the boy, even if he's not the brightest. And the girls will take a secondary position within the family. The resources will be committed to making sure the boy has a better education, is sent abroad, if that's what it means. Whereas the girls who may be far brighter academically, doing much, much better than their brothers, will not get the same opportunity. That is something that we have to work on. It's a mindset change, but I see that coming as well. There's no question about that at all. I mean, no country in the world today can call itself a cultured country, a civilized country, a progressive country, or even a modern country, so long as even a single girl in that country remains illiterate. And what we have today is a fairly aggressive drive to making sure that our girls in India get that opportunity to at least compete fairly on a level playing field, because they won't be denied access to education. The denial to education was one of the biggest social blunders that India had committed. I hope that we are setting that equation right, because an empowered girl, an educated girl, means necessarily an empowered society and an empowered community, and by definition, an empowered country. And we hope that there will be an empowered world led by every single girl in the world, not just in India, being an educated woman with a voice and with a mind that she can use constructively and for bettering not just herself, but the world at large. Educating the girl child has to be priority number one for our country. If we are going to see a better India, each one of us is obliged to contribute. If we don't do that, there is something wrong with our conscience, and there's something wrong with our vision for our country. The moment you educate a little girl, you see the difference almost instantly. And as they say, you educate a girl, you see, you educate a village. And especially in our villages, I can see several initiatives, but anybody who can contribute even their little bit towards that initiative is today's hero. And it's not all that tough. No one is asking you to give more than you can afford. Just 500 rupees can transform a girl's life. It can educate that little girl for one entire month. Think about that.